Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Bastion Slot, and we are back playing Zoo Tycoon 2. And after the intensity of the last few episodes, you know, we've done big exhibits, we've done Jurassic Park, we've done the Mosasaurus, we've done the fancy shark tank, blah blah. We're going to do some sort of slightly more low-key stuff now. We're going to do some little exhibits, two in particular, that I've got in mind. First things first, the exhibit that I completely forgot I could do in the last episode. We need to get ourselves a goddamn sloth, ladies and gentlemen. So let's go find the little bucket. It's definitely here. It's definitely here. Somewhere. I know it's on the bottom row, and it's near the giant ground sloth. I saw it. I know I missed it like a million times in the other episode, two episodes ago. But now, I will hunt it down, and I shall make it mine. Mr. Sloth, where are you? See, this is the thing, right? I know it's here. I'm 100% sure. But now that I'm looking for it, I'm pretty sure I won't find it. Come on, little sloth. Come on. I know you're here somewhere. I saw you. I checked the video. There it is! Ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves a sloth. So what we're going to do is basically a, don't know why I'd want a tank, an exhibit for sloths and koalas and red pandas. We're going to do like a treetop kind of exhibit. It's going to be pretty cool, I think. So a nice low fence. I've got an idea kind of based on how they look in zoos of how we're going to build this. I'd like a nice low wooden fence, I think. Cable fence, that'll do. Meow. You want to be able to see in, don't you? It's a sloth. Oh, why aren't you curvy? Why are you never curvy? Actually, that bit looks really good with the glass there. I know, I should mention this. I know this drop isn't actually on the right bit. In the film, basically, this bit here would be wilderness and woods, but it was flush with the bridge up there. And that would be the area where, so this is the thingy over there. They find Malcolm and they drive, don't they? They drive dinosaur poop. They don't drive dinosaur poop. They drive down this way, away from the exhibit, I think. In the car when they're running. Oh, hello. When they're trying to escape from the T-Rex. I should probably put a boundary around there, shouldn't I? Anyways, so technically the drop should actually be sort of over here, I think. A lot of you mentioned this and stuff, but the problem is that's stupid. Basically. I don't really have another explanation for it. I know the T-Rex would be separated from it, but you wouldn't want to risk the T-Rex breaking through, or during a power cut, the T-Rex falling down a cliff, stuff like that. This, I think, is actually a better design. You are welcome, Jurassic Park. I will accept monetary value for my suggestions. Right. So, tropical rainforest, lovely. Is that tropical? It doesn't look like tropical. There we go. You need the dirt, otherwise it doesn't really work. So, the idea is nice and simple. We're not doing anything too fancy with this. It's a sloth. It's a maybe koala, but it's definitely a red panda because that kind of makes more sense. And we're going to make a little bit of a hill. So a nice big brush, I think. In my head, this is how these exhibits always go, because you don't want them able to, we have to flatten this a little bit. You don't want them able to escape. You don't want them running away. You don't want them jumping over the edge. So there's always like a mound in the middle. Mound is an awful word, by the way. There's always like a mound in the middle where they predominantly live. And then there's like a gap around the outside, usually with water. So that's probably where we'll put like a little river. So smooth all this out. Make it nice and calm. Nice and calm. Let's have a look at that. It's a little too moundy, I think we'll all agree. Too much of a mound. Let's just flatten that out. Okay, there we go. And smooth it out. Smooth it out. Now it's actually a ditch instead of a mound, so it's kind of the opposite of what I'm going for. It's quite hard with the, it's easier, oddly enough, with the cliff tool to get good shapes. Quite hard with this one. Bloody Nora, you are making life difficult, aren't you? Smooth it out. Smooth it out. It's going to look fine. It's going to look fine. Smooth it out. Lovely, lovely. Let's call that done. Okay, so we need a little bit of shallow water. Thin brush, just all the way around the edges. That's definitely more of a cliff than I intended it to be, actually. We'll have to have a look at that. Oh, splendid. Okay, I've made a little waterfall. Not really my intention, must be said. That is never going to be fixed now, that little gap there. That is a permanent fixture, unfortunately. Let's move all this out. Smooth it out. But don't ruin the waterfall. The mini waterfall's... Oh, no, it isn't. Kind of cool. It's kind of broken my path completely. Huh. Okay, this isn't going that well. Actually, that is kind of precisely what I was looking for in terms of that shape. If not, just a little bit bigger in the middle. I think my problem is the hill tool makes hills quicker than I expect it to, you know? It's got a more prominent effect than I anticipate. And my solution for this yellow path is to delete the path. Look at that, it's beautiful. There's no problems whatsoever. And you can still get through this way, so it's fine. Okay, so... Shelter. No shelter. Huh. Let's put some nice trees in. Nice big trees. These are tiny trees. That's more like it. Bam, 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 bam. Okay, that's just being weird. Why is it being weird? Just sit on the hill and don't be difficult about it. You silly so-and-so. Little ones every now and again. I want it to look verdant, you know? It should have life to it. And let's move that, smooth it out, smooth it out. It's gone slightly crazy. Not really sure why or what to do about it. It'll be fine, whatever. It was just a little bit of fun. Ooh, a lookout post. That's cool. It's got one of those. Put one of these in as well. Maybe a couple of them. And a couple of lookout. These are awesome. All right, I'm going to put one on the sides. I want the sloth to get on and look out towards the world. That's cool. It's like a little forest retreat. Let's put some little plants in. And when I say some, I mean lots and 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 lots. Once again, just really want it to feel like it's an actual real woodland kind of place, you know? I'm going to look after my sloths. Well, predictably. I don't look after many animals, but I will look after my sloths. Okay, and a couple more trees, maybe? Little ones. I just really want it to feel like verdant woodland. I'm going to keep using the word verdant. It's my word for the day. Lots of different coloured trees, lots of different little things, little... And that in the middle instead. The king tree, as it shall now be known. King tree. Gonna save it, folks. I'm really freakishly paranoid about... That's why I'm... Okay, hopefully you can actually still hear this for a brief moment. It crashed whilst I went to save it. File is corrupted or otherwise unreadable. Unable to load game. Ladies and gentlemen, Mrow 2 has officially died. Right. Okay, folks, we've had to kind of restart, as you can see. Brand new zoo, brand new thingamajiggy. Same old map, but whatever. This is just kind of how it has to be, unfortunately, because apparently trees kill zoos. And I think it really is a problem with too many trees. So every now and again, we're kind of going to restart and just kind of scrap the old stuff, unfortunately. But, not to worry. We are now ready. I've made it again. It's a little bit smoother. I don't think... It looks as good in some ways, but let's have quite a few little sloths in here, shall we? So excited. Please move, please move, please work, please work. Yay! Hello? Hello? Aren't you the cutest little thing? Oh god, alright. The bamboo. I put in some bamboo and I instantly regretted it because it looks stupid. Let's get rid of the bamboo. Okay.
little sloppy.
Wait, I want you to climb the lookout thing. Look at them! They're so cute! How do I crouch? I'm sure there's a way to crouch. I can't remember how.
Hiya! Hiya! Hello! You're the cutest little thing.
Can I put you on it? Can I just like stick you literally on top? What? You can't even pick you up? Elephant ear tree. Splendid. I actually can't pick the sloths. I wonder why I can't pick the sloths up. I literally am incapable of doing it. Wow, okay. They've also got this thing. It's like a climbing frame with food on top. It's cool. It's a nice little exhibit. The waters are maybe not worked out. Except bamboo! Bamboo must die. Bamboo's awful. I really don't know why I put it in. It looks like a little rainforest, you know? And you wander around, and every now and again, there's a little sloth crawling about. Like... there. Bamboo! Okay, let's try it.
Hello, little sloughy!
Okay, I'm in love. I'm happy. I can die happy now. I'm done. I retire. Because they're just so cute. Right, we're also going to add a red panda. Which is there. Now, they need temperate forests. Do you need anything different in terms of... bamboo? Okay, I'll just stick some of that around where possible. And they should be okay with the stuff I've already got. A little shelter, maybe? Oh, what's that? That's cute! Okay, I want to put this in, but... ah! Okay, elevated nest box for the red panda. And some little mushrooms. Why not? Some teeny tiny ones. And then big mushroom. And then little ones. Out. And then some different colours. Like a little mushroom patch. And let's put a couple of red pandas in. So, Daisy. There we go. Red pandas and sloths together at last. Hello. Look, they're friends. Sorry, I can't provide witty or entertaining commentary. I'm just over, like, two of the cutest and my favourite animals in the world are, like, together. Hello, children, look at it. Look how marvellous and cute it is. This sloth, I wish they'd climb the things, admittedly, because it looks a little silly than just climbing around on the ground. It'd be nice if they climbed trees, but I can understand why that would be difficult to put in the game, so. Can I get rid of my camera's photos thing? Ah!
Hello! Look at the best friends!
Best buddies forever! Yay. I just want to get a good screen. Yay! Best buddies forever. Okay! Now that's done. We have a brand new... look, the children love it. The other thing we're going to do today is, again, like I said, we're definitely going to do small exhibits today. It's very early in the morning. I'm just gonna chill for a little bit and we're gonna do some basic exhibits. But this was a suggestion someone gave me, which I thought was pretty cute and also accurate to normal zoos, because this is our problem, right? We've spent a lot of time doing just... there's been a lot of dinosaurs, which is cool. Dinosaurs are cool. We know this. But it has meant that we've kind of neglected stuff like sloths and red pandas and such. So, in order to make this feel a bit more like a normal zoo, we are going to do an indoors-outdoors exhibit. You know, there's a lot of zoos where they'll have a little outdoor exhibit, and then they'll have a little home, and you can go in, you'll see it from the glass on the outside, and you'll look into their little home where they sleep. So we're going to do that with a pygmy hippopotamus. Hippopotamus. So, there. Because it's adorable, little guy. Okay. So, what we need to do is we need to use two types of fencing. Three types of fencing, actually, if we're going to do this properly. So let's do a brick wall, I think. A low one, though. And let me think this through. About there. And then there. This is the sort of open air. That's a bit small, isn't it, really? Let's make it a bit bigger. It's only a pygmy hippo. It's not big. Is that enough room? That's enough room. So that's going to be their kind of outdoors play area, whatever you want to call it. Then we need a wooden wall. How big's that? That's pretty perfect. Is it? So we're going to have to put a roof on this, so it's going to have to be taller than that. Four. Is four big enough? Four's too big. Three. Is that the same size as the thing I used a minute ago? I think it might be. Let's put that there. I kind of got an idea of how this is going to work in my head. This is actually a bit too big in general for what I was hoping for, but that's okay. And then four, we get this. We put that along. Okay. Three. Yep. Three that along there. And then we get rid of this.
that in the middle? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No. Bam. There we go. Lovely jubbly. And now we need to put a roof on top of that. So, elevator path. And which one do we like? Something has to look wooden. You look pretty wooden. You look pretty wooden. Everyone looks pretty. You look pretty wooden. I like you. Is that perfect? You might be. No, you're a little low, aren't you? Yeah. There we go. Yeah, it'll do. Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I wish there was a way to get rid of this little edge. But whatever. It's going to look cool. It's going to look cool. It's going to look like what I'm aiming for, anyway. I think. A little pygmy hippos. Pygmy hippos. How can you be thirsty? There's a river surrounding your home. I'm going to give them some water. I know it's probably unnecessary. But people always tell me it's unnecessary. And then I always have creatures bitching about the lack of water. So it's worth doing, I think. Okay, biome. Yep. Yeah. And let's just pop this little guy up. Boop. This is the greatest thing in the world, by the way. I love it. And fill in there. Okay. So now we need to differentiate between the two. So the outside can have a bit of water. Just about. Actually, it's a hippo. Hippos like water. Let's give them quite a bit. And we'll give them a little bit of deep as well, just in this corner bit here. Not much, just enough to have a little play around in. Lovely jubbly. All the food goes inside, in like a food pile in the corner. So, pile of bananas there. And some hay. This kind of thing always has lots of hay in, so let's just put lots of hay knocking about. And a couple of water dishes as well over here. Nice and separate. Lovely jubbly. And outside they get a little treat, they get a hollow log with some apples. Their toys go out, so this can sit outside as well, actually. A couple of balls just floating around. Doing ball kind of things, you know? I like this tree. Look at this little guy. Pachoo, pachoo. And some little ones, yeah. Don't want it to look too crowded, really. Okay, plants. What's this? Bamboo! Never trust the bamboo. What do we like? What do we like? We like this. We like ferns. Ferns are cool. Not inside, though. Not inside. We're actually going to change the inside. I've got kind of an idea. Right. Rocks? A little rock. A little rock over there. Hippos love rocks. Everyone knows that. Food they've got. Water they've got. Enrichment shelter. Right. I can't put that inside. That should be... No, no. It's going to be fine. It's going to be fine. It's going to be fine. I have full confidence in my beautiful little indoors place that it's going to be hunky-dory. Give them a scratch. No, we won't. Okay, so what I actually want, and this might seem silly, probably because it is, but sand. Ooh. I must hate sand. What am I doing? Never mind. I thought it'd be kind of cool as an idea, but I think it's just daft. And little ball. Gotta have big balls, gotta have little balls, gotta have all types of balls. And what's this? Let's put that in the water. Okay. I think that's pretty much all I was looking for, really. Nothing complicated, nothing fancy, just a little double pygmy hippo thing. I'll put them inside. It's big enough that we can have four, actually. Always like to put them in couples, you know? Okay, so, meow, if we're down here. Oh, right, yeah. Oops, Daisy. Yeah, there we go. Hey, it's pretty cute. Little outdoors bit, and you run down here. Can't see in that side. No, no, no. But you come around the corner. It's a little big. I would have liked it to be smaller. I think smaller would have made more sense. We're also going to put some water inside. Which kind of goes against the whole idea. But whatever. They need water, the hippos. And then they got an inside bin, and they got an outside bin, and they're having the time of the... Look at it, it's cute. I like it, I'm chuffed. It may be simple, But whatever, it's cute. And that's more important than anything. Never let anyone tell you differently. They're liars. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. Ladles and gentle spoons. What else can I call you? Humans! Humans. Hello, humans. That's all we're going to do today. Nice and simple episode, I think. We're just going to kind of relax a little bit after the intensity. But you guys have given me some fantastic ideas, as per usual, over the past couple of episodes. Stuff that we can integrate in the next episode in a couple of days, or whenever the devil it may be. And I am, as always, still looking for more. We're still going to do, to let you guys know what the kind of plans are right now, I'd like to do a pterosaur aviary, like a proper big chain link aviary. We're going to try to do the one from Jurassic Park 3. It's going to be impossible. We can't do the cliffs. My idea is basically there's going to be a river in the middle of it. So it's going to be Jurassic Park 3 without the cliffs and the bridge. So basically nothing like Jurassic Park 3. Otherwise you can't make it an aviary, because as we saw when we first made the aviary, if you put water on the ground, it lowers the height of the roof, unfortunately. So we can't really do that. This looks like a normal zoo now. It's very weird. Anyways. So aviary. Somebody recommended we recreate Jaws. So we're going to do that. We're going to make like a little beach with some deep water. We're going to put a big great white shark in there. Put a couple of humans on there and some balls and stuff like that to try and make it look a little bit like a beach. It's going to be difficult to do. We'll put some cars and stuff like that. And what else? What else? What else? A couple of suggestions from Walking with Dinosaurs and Planet Dinosaur stuff. I still want to do like a Mayan pyramid kind of thing. That was a really cool idea. I'm still trying to figure out how exactly we'd do it, but I've got some rough ideas involving lots of bridges and stuff. I know. Nice to do a little chilled episode. Next episode we'll probably work on the Jaws thing, but as always, I am not pre-recording these ahead of time. I do these the day they go up, so your suggestions are always noted from the previous episode. So feel free to suggest away. Thank you very much for joining me. As per usual, I shall see you lovely folks in the next episode. And before we do that, that's going to be our little hippos.
Hello, little hippos. Hello, little hippos.
Okay. Wait, when I clean it, it goes rubbish looking. It looks better when it's dirty. You're better when you're dirty. Look, cool. Rubbish. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye.